Alright, I don't know why it didn't record this before, but it only recorded like 8 seconds. I just watched a video from Minute Physics, it was released a few days ago, about the so-called portal paradox. Basically, if you brought a portal down on top of a cube, would the cube simply just flop out of the other portal? Or would it fly out of the portal with the same velocity that the moving portal had? And the answer given at the end of the video was the game says one thing and physics says another thing, but the answer can be whatever you want it to be because we're talking about something fictional that doesn't exist. I reject that answer. The answer that I came up with is really simple. Let's imagine that you're standing in a room, right? And before you is a door leading into another room. Now let's say that this wall is movable. You can move this wall, or the wall is able to move on its own. Now let's say that this wall starts moving towards you at 50 miles an hour. And with where you're standing, you simply pass through the doorway of this wall. Do you suddenly fly forward at 50 miles an hour? No. If you're standing still, you remain completely stationary. The door moved relative to you. Space moved relative to you. I mean, in old English books, a doorway is referred to as a portal. I forget why I brought that. Anyway, so you've passed through this portal. You've moved from one space to another space. Except, actually, space has moved around you, technically, in this sense. But you're still not moving. You don't suddenly start moving at 50 miles an hour. Now, let's say you have a rubber band on your hand, and you're about to fire it. You're gonna fire it through the door. You fire it through the door, okay? It has left one space, entered another space. That rubber band maintains its velocity through the doorway, okay? Now let's say that same rubber band, same doorway, but the doorway starts moving towards you as you fire the rubber band. The wall is moving, the doorway is moving towards you at 50 miles an hour, and you fire that rubber band, and let's just say it's going, I don't know, 2 miles an hour. It doesn't matter, we're not doing any math. That rubber band will pass, it will travel through space at 2 miles an hour, and it will pass through that doorway. But when it exits the doorway, and it's on the other side, it is not magically going 52 miles an hour, it is still only going to be moving 2 miles an hour. It is going to maintain its velocity. You can just common sense that. If you're standing still, you fire that rubber band, it's traveling 2 miles an hour. It's not going to stop traveling at 2 miles an hour just because you fired it through a doorway that's moving towards you. It's not going to magically gain velocity just because it passed through a door. The same thing can be said about these portals. So it's at this point where I started getting my terms mixed up. I mixed up portal and cube for a little bit. So if you could just kind of bear with me and understand that I got my terms backwards, that would be great. Sorry for the confusion. If you had that cube coming down on top of a portal, and let's say the other portal is up on a wall, that portal is just going to fall down. It's going to fall straight down off the wall. And even if the portal isn't able to make full contact with the floor and technically the hole and doesn't technically engulf the entire cube, at a certain point gravity takes over, and as more and more of the cube comes out of the wall, gravity will just take over and pull the rest of the cube the rest of the way out. It's not going to magically gain velocity just because that portal came down at the speed of sound. That's not how it works. And then he posed a question at the end of the video. If you dropped something through the portal as it was moving side to side, Would it come up out of the next portal straight up, or would it fly off at an angle? It would just come straight up, because again, it doesn't matter if the portal is moving. It would come straight up. Even if it's one of those things where it like destroys the original and then rebuilds a copy, it would still just come straight up. Well, maybe not. If it destroys the original and then creates a copy, then there's a chance it wouldn't even go anywhere, because then the portal would have to be applying momentum for, it would have to apply a forward energy in order for that to happen, and that's not what the portals do. They don't, in the game, they don't accelerate anything. Gravity does that in the game. All the portals do in the game is allow you to maintain energy, maintain velocity. So it would probably reconstruct and then deconstruct and then come right back out. You would probably see exactly something similar to what happens in the game if you did that. Maybe. You'd have to actually be able to do it to say conclusively what would happen, but I'm pretty confident that if it just straight up acts like a doorway, then it would just come straight out, no matter what. So, that's my answer. The portals are just doorways. That's how they act in the game, that's how they behave in the game. So, if we had real portals that actually behaved like they do in the game, at least as far as like gameplay is concerned, it would just be a doorway. It's really not that hard, guys. It's not hard to understand.